In step two, let's add an image to our project. To do that, I'm going to toggle over to that images folder that I downloaded and come in and select an image. I'm looking for the talon.jpg file, and I see it here in the folder. What I want to do is just press and drag this image here into the gray circle on that home screen. Now, I'm going to do it wrong for a moment just to show you what happens. As I drag this image onto the canvas, I get a highlight indicating where I'm placing that image. So I see a blue highlight, and when I click and release, sadly, my good friend Talon here has a hole in his head. So that's not what I wanted to do. I'm going to hit Undo or Command-Z on the Mac, Control-Z on Windows, and go back to that directory and grab the image and press and drag it. But this time I'm going to drag right into that gray area. Notice that the highlight goes from the rectangle to the gray area. And when I release, the image is placed there. That looks pretty good, but I want to actually control the mask on the image, both its size and placement. To do that, with the image selected here, I'm going to double click, which takes me into that mask layer. Let's go ahead and zoom in a little tighter so that I can see more what I'm doing. So I've got the image selected. I'm in the mask layer. I can press and drag now to just resize it a bit larger and then drag to place the image towards the center of the circle. And when I hit escape or click off, it will unselect the mask and let me look at that placed image within the design.